everybody, this is BTSPRO, and today I'm going to be drawing Lilo from Lilo and Stitch. You can go check out the Stitch video if you want to. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to kind of keep this one a little bit simpler. But let's get started. First thing we're going to do is, of course, as always, we're going to draw out a ball. So after we draw in our ball shape, or our circle, let's go ahead and put in our construction lines. And after we get that drawn in, let's go ahead and add in her cheek and her jawline. Right here where this intersects the ball is where we're going to start. So we're just going to kind of come on around, and probably going to end up, let's say, about right there. So let's gauge for that. Okay. All right. Now that we got her head started, hopefully this is good for everybody. We're going to come back in, and then we're going to add in her body. Now this is one of the poses where she's actually doing a hula dance. So what we're going to do is we're going to come in, let's say, about right here, and we're going to create this very large shape. Kind of looks like a crazy eye. Now, where we came off of here, you know, we're going to come all around and get to add in her arms. So this is her shoulder. So we're going to come through here, through the ball, through her jawline, and we're going to come out. And this kind of looks a little bit like a big sausage to me. But the gentleman that created these characters, his name was Chris, and I'm having trouble remembering his last name right now, but he drew a lot of the heaviness toward the forward part of the arms. I kind of like saying the stylized Popeye arm. You know, this is, we're going to add a circle here, and we're going to come off about right here, and we're going to add another. This is her other arm, right? So we'll come back, we'll end somewhere right here, and we want to make sure we add in our circle for her hand. This is her palm, and that's very important to remember. Let's jump back up. Let's jump back up to her face. She had this big wreath on, but you also got to remember that she has this really beautiful black hair. So let's go ahead and add in some hair, just kind of where you want to. Let's say and remember, we're three-dimensional, so we're going to be coming in behind here. So she has some hair that comes down there. Just come off the head a little bit. You know, kind of lightly put in the hair if you want to at the top, because that'll be erased, because she has this little, like, wreath on. Head wreath on. So, see, it'll come back out about right there. And then we'll just kind of draw her hair in, kind of like Ariel. I like that. Let's add in the wreath part. This is all just kind of preliminary lines, right? So we'll just kind of make this graceful shape here. All right, let's come back to her hands. Now this is a classic way of drawing Disney hands, and what you're going to do is you're going to kind of create this. It almost looks like a fin on the top, and then like a little fishtail coming at the bottom, and kind of the same way over here. We're going to come off here, come down, and make sure you mix up. Don't try to recreate this hand over here. Then we'll add her little thumb right here. It's pretty cool. Now, like I said, all these are just kind of like blocking in for later on, because this shape here also entails her skirt. So we want to make sure that we get that as well. These little things I'm drawing in right now. These are her wrist decorations. Okay. And she's looking a little weird to me right now, so we've got to put some feet in there. So on the shape here, I should have done this before. I'm sorry. But you see this part where it ends right there? We're going to come right off of that, and we're going to pretend like we're drawing a three-dimensional shape. Right? Then we're going to come in about right here, and we're going to subdivide this shape as well. All right, and that kind of gives you an idea of circledness or weight to it. But we're going to come right off of this point. Maybe we'll move over just a little bit, and we're just going to rough in her foot shape. And of course, there's another one under her skirt right over here. And there's also this. Let me put the top of the foot in too. That might help a little bit. Huh? There's also this. She also has like these decorations on her ankles or on her feet. So we got to make sure we put those in there. And I guess I need to go back in here and put in this other piece of hair. Might help. Now right here where I stopped on this line, this is also going to be her ear line as well. So we're going to come off a little bit and then come down. Hopefully you can see that on the drawing. Let's go ahead and get in her eyes and her nose. But let's start off, of course, with her nose. Now, if you drew your lines, which I hope you did, drew them soft so you can see this, what we're going to do is we're going to draw her nose starts off kind of in a ball shape. And then, like I said before, if you were to divide the ball from north to south, you drew right through the middle, that's usually where you'll find her eye, where the eye ends up, roughly, bam. And her eyes are almond-shaped, so if you could draw, like if this line was drawn all around, it would like go right through here. And, of course, her mouth is slightly over-exaggerated because she's having a good time hula dancing because that's all she wants to do. Of course, she's got to go feed the fish, pug, if I remember right. And let's put her other part of her eye right there. And I'll adjust that in a second. So, yeah, that looks pretty good. Okay. I'm going to erase a little bit more. In this part right here, she has like a hula skirt on or top on, so make sure that you put that in there. And make sure, sometimes people call what I've called tangents before. Make sure that you see this little line point right here. You want to come above that a little bit and then go across this way, because it creates what they call a visual tangent. And it can also, the visual tangents can also ruin the illusion of three-dimensionality. So you got to make sure that you are very mindful of tangents. All right, now that we're ready to start adding in, I kind of erased her just a little bit so you can see some of the details that are going on. But let's go ahead and start adding in. And of course, we're going to save the face for last. So let's go ahead and start working around everywhere else. So let's start in on the hands. And what we're going to do is we're going to add in her fingers. So we'll start off here with her pinky, and we'll come up here and we'll add in all the fingers. And hands are just a matter of practice. And be a little bit clearer in cleanup. Come to the other side. And the interesting thing about fingers is they really are just not really just a matter of practicing and getting them right. So practice your practice, or I'm always practice drawing, But I always practice, you know, these little hard details that we find in these characters, because to me, hands have always been a struggle, because you would think it'd be something easy to do. Now, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go ahead and start adding in leaf details. Cool. Let's come up here on her arm. You know how we drew it around here? Let's put a little bit there, and let's add another line here, which gives us, and what you wanna do is come off of this line. We come out off the body a little bit, and we come around, and we do like that. And now that's part of her upper, upper part of her bathing suit, or her hula dancing outfit. I really loved this movie. It was one of the last movies done, I believe, down at the Disney Studios in Burbank, at the Hollywood Studios, then known as MGM. And this movie was completely done down there, if my sources are correct. So what we'll do now is let's go ahead and deal with her hula skirt a little bit. You know, this line here that we've created, what we're going to do is we're going to take it a little bit further out, and then we're going to bulge it down. And what that does is that gives us a sense that very three-dimensional, right? So let's go ahead and, you know, just kind of freeform. Let's go ahead and, you know, this B shape here, this is part of her hair. Let's come in a little bit and let's go ahead and kind of give her hair a little bit more character. Make her ear just a little bigger. All right, since we've revealed more of her foot down here, let's go ahead and add in toes. And kind of like what I did with Simba last time, just kind of get you an idea. It's little circles, since there's the edge of the foot, you're not gonna do that. You can just bring them around like this. Kind of give them a little flat on the bottom. It'll be more evident in the cleanup, because she's putting weight on them. Make sure you end up with four toes. And of course you have a little bit of the foot disappearing off to the back behind this little piece right here. So, and you can shade that in darker to help it a little bit more. And of course, since we have the visible foot, we have this part right here. We kind of have to do something a little different here. So what we're going to do is add in a little bit more detail. Maybe something down here. It'll be like part of the leaf. In there. I may add those later and clean up. So now that we got that moved in, let's go ahead and move into her facial features. And I usually will start in the center of the face, and there's no different here. So let's bring her nose back on, and her nose is actually very prominent. And she has this little niche in there, which is her nostril. And if you kind of want to give a hint of another one over there, you can. Her mouth doesn't really change too much from the actual, except you're going to make the top lip a little bit longer. And instead of being such a sharp line there, we're going to round it off, bring it down. And I'm going to pull it up a little bit because I feel like I got another visual tangent going on right there. We will add in her tongue. So let's go ahead and knock out some of this hair up here. You know, we're just gonna kinda add little wisps to it. Just where it kinda looks like it more belongs. We'll probably add some, first we'll add leaves up here. You don't wanna add a little dimensionality to the hair, you know. Make sure that it looks pretty believable that it's supposed to be hair. So okay, cool. Now what we'll do is this halo effect that we're going on, we know that she is definitely not a saintly character, but a boom. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just kinda start adding in leaves. And if anybody wondering what I keep looking at off screen, it is the fact that I keep looking over at the computer monitor to make sure that the darkness is coming along pretty good. So there we go. Let me slide back out of the way because I'm drawing this at a funny angle. It's not the easiest thing in the world. All right. And let's not forget the detail in our ear. Usually I would just draw, up here, some people would just draw like an H. I doubt you can see that, maybe you can. But we're not going to do that. We're gonna do a little bit more of the actual shape of the ear. So just kinda, you know, have fun with it. And I used to know all the terms for all the anatomy of the ear, but it's been a long time, so I'm not up on it. Let's go ahead and add in her pupils. And you're just going to kind of, she's looking at you, but her head's kind of at a three-quarter view. And you can just kind of, she's got big eyes. Let's make sure that we add in her eyebrow. There's one there, and you really can't see the other one over there, but if you want to kind of put one in there, you can, but it would be just a little. This is an ebony pencil. It is made by Prismacolor. Everybody, sometimes I get questions about my drawing pencil. Mine is actually made by Faber-Castell? F-A-B-E-R, and that looks like Castle. It's a TK-9400, and it's actually what they call a lead holder. So it's not really a pencil. So it just gives you an idea. You know, if you want to make her hair a little more fuller, you can. Just kind of take some of the straightness off of it and erase the lines you don't want to use. Okay, fine work up to this point. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and start coloring her in, filling in her lines. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial so far. And now that we've kind of got it to this point, we can start in our line work. So I'm gonna start way over here first and then we'll go from there. I almost forgot. She is a human, so we're going to give her a belly button. Put that right there, will be good. Alright, so here we have our lined in here, a little bit cleaned up line. So now what we're going to do is go ahead and shade her, and see you in a second. I'm just going to draw a line, but if you want to, you can to anchor the character on the paper. You can put like a shadow, and of course shade it in. It kind of gives your character a little bit of an anchor on the page. So, all right, well, there's my Lilo, and so let me sign it. Copyright Disney and my signature. So, and it's 2013. So I hope you all have enjoyed this tutorial, and I will see y'all again real soon, I hope.